second verse. In the bid to continue investing online via your cases and learning from the effects of COVID-19, the judiciary has installed additional video conferencing system, bringing the total now to 17. And these are the Supreme Court, the Court of Appeal, the High Court at Kampala, the Commercial Court and the Criminal Division, 11 High Court circuits, Mbarara, Arua, Masindi, Masaka, Jinja, Soroti, Hira, Potipoto, Kamala, Mbari, Uganda Road, Chikwa District Court. Mr. Chairman, you can see that we have moved very, very fast. We are trying to see that we cover even the other courts in the next few years. Number two is the provision of computers and laptops to judicial officers as working tools. In the financial year 2021, the proportion of judicial officers with both computer desktops and laptops was only 52%. Now, the cumulative progress is that the effects of COVID-19 necessitated the judicial officers can work from anywhere in order to facilitate judicial officers to write judgments. Computers, desktops, and laptops were provided. As at October last month, all officers, all judicial officers, have computer, desktops, and laptops. So it is now improved performance as a result of having these tools. Provision of online legal reference materials in the financial year 2020-21, access to online legal and search database for judicial officers, such as LexisNexis, was only 487. But as we talk today, in October 2024, access to online digital legal and research databases for judicial officers stands at 750. This is a very, very big progress. What does this mean? It means that many judicial officers can access these materials online and make informed decisions. Expansion of the internet infrastructure in courts. In the year 2020-2021, the coverage of internet in courts across the country stood at 39%. As at October 2024, the average internet in courts across the country stands now at 46%. We need to make it even more as we receive funds. The second commitment was to instill zero tolerance for corruption in the judicial system by introducing systems and periodic monitoring of judicial officers. Chair, four approaches. The first one is to do with electronic court case management information system. What is ECMIS? ECMIS is an IT-based system that automates the entire process of a court case life cycle, right from the filing to the archival. The ECMIS was commissioned in 2021, and the ECMIS Go Live was launched on 1st March 2022. This ECMIS as a tool helps us to check corruption. Why? Because it minimizes human-to-human contact in the delivery of services, and thus reduces incidences of corruption. A number of complaints have been registered of people who go to courts to find, and they find difficulties, or they find inconveniences when some of the employees of judiciary ask them for seats to go. Now we are trying to eliminate that so that